Do you know that Microsoft's new artificial intelligence tool allows you to convert your Word document into a well-formatted visual PowerPoint presentation in just one click? You can even pick up any web article that you really liked, copy and paste the text onto a Word document like this, and then with a single click, you would be able to generate a well-formatted presentation that looks like this, complete with smart art, visuals, and everything. That's what you will learn today. If it sounds interesting, keep watching. Hi, I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com. We make creative PowerPoint tutorials to help professionals make impactful presentations. If this is your first time to this channel, consider hitting the subscribe button and the bell notification so you don't miss anything. Before we jump in, let me make it clear that you need Microsoft 365 subscription for this feature to work. Now, with that out of the way, let us start the magic from scratch. The first thing you need is to find Microsoft Word Online. So let me go here and say Word Online. When I hit enter, you can see that we have this first result in the search. You click and that will open up Microsoft Word Online page that looks like this. Then let me click on New Blank Document and that will open up a new document like this. Then let us go to Google and research a topic. I'm going to say how to, maybe write, because that is one of the suggestions that I can see here, and better emails. Yeah, that sounds like a good topic. So let me click on how to write better emails. And I have quite a few interesting suggestions here. This one is quite nice. It says 10 ways to write better emails. So I'm going to click and open that article. The next thing I'm going to do is to select all the text that I see here and copy it onto my Word document. Now I selected everything, press Ctrl C to copy, then go to this blank Word document that we opened, then right click and paste. Now what that did is it copied the article onto my Word document. I can of course remove all the unnecessary things like these ads here. Now we have the cleaned up document. Now, all I need to do to convert this Word document into a PowerPoint presentation is to go to File, then go to Export. Then we have this ready-made option called Export to PowerPoint Presentation. You click on that option and that gives you this dialog box. It says we are fetching design themes and here are the various design themes that you can choose from. I'm going to choose this option here and I'm going to say Export. Now, the artificial intelligence of Microsoft does its thing. Now, all I need to do is to open the presentation by clicking on this. Here I have the presentation opened in PowerPoint Online. It is saved to OneDrive. I can click on this and I can give it a different name. Let us say Better Emails. You can see that it is .pptx file. I'm going to hit enter. Now watch that it is getting stored in OneDrive root folder. So let me hit enter here. So it is saved. Now let us quickly go through the presentation that is created. When I go to slideshow, you can see how the presentation looks. This is the first paragraph. This is the first tip. See how the tip is quite beautifully placed onto the left and the content is nicely presented as a smart art onto the right. I can go down. This is the second tip and the third tip here and observe the icons here. The text here says, if not, let's talk. And you can see that the right icon is chosen by Microsoft. And it says, I think, launching the new campaign. And you can see that we have a nice appropriate icon introduced. I can go down and this is the fourth tip. We have the fifth tip and so on. So the entire presentation is made from a Word document that we just copied from the net. Now, let us take this to the next level. I can go to the first page and we are going to change the title here. Let us say Better Emails. Now, when I see onto the right, I have this designer option that gives me different ways in which I can have my title design. I can go up and I see that this is a pretty good design. So I'm going to select that and instantly the slide is changed and I now have a beautiful looking title slide design. I can make all the changes to this slide just as if I had created this slide all on my own. Then let me go down and here I see one big idea per email. I want to see if there is a way that I can replace this with a better image. So let me go down here and here I have the option to search for pictures. See how intelligent this artificial intelligence of Microsoft is? It gives you suggestions for these keywords. It says main thing, key takeaway, conversation, big idea, etc. I want a visual for big idea, so let me click on that option. Now, Microsoft had done the search on the web and I have these nice images. I'm going to select this image. Now, with that image inside, now when I see the designer option, I have quite a few interesting new suggestions. I like this suggestion better, so I'm going to select that, and instantly my slide is remade and my slide design includes the new image that I have. If I don't want this image, I can delete it and I will have a new set of ideas generated, and this one looks even more interesting, and I now have an appropriate image in the background and I have the headline for the slide quite nicely placed on the slide. Now, what you saw here is the result of a random article that I picked up from a random search, and this is the design and this is the kind of result you got. Imagine the kind of results you would get when you have a well-formatted document that you want to convert into a presentation. Now, how does this slide creation happen? How does PowerPoint recognize the various titles and the content inside? It's very simple. Microsoft looks for logical section dividers in a document and creates slides appropriately. Right now, the conversion is only for the words, and it's not for the images and icons that you see as part of the document that you have created. Which means once the conversion is done, Microsoft does its own thing to insert the appropriate images. Of course, you have all the liberty to go down and search for different options here and make your presentation more visual. But it doesn't automatically pick up the images and icons that you got in your original document and include it as part of the presentation. Now, to improve your Microsoft Word knowledge a bit more, I've created a short playlist of videos that includes 5 Microsoft Word tips you didn't know. So click on the video that you see here right away and improve your Microsoft Word skills even more.